Today, we're going to learn the concept of torque on a current carrying loop placed in uniform magnetic field. This video will help us get a good understanding of the term torque and how a current carrying loop, which is placed in the uniform magnetic field, experiences the torque. Let's begin, shall we? Torque is defined as the product of force and the length of lever arm. Recall that the current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field experiences the magnetic force. F is equal to BIL sine theta. In vector form, vector F is equal to I times vector L cross vector B. When a current carrying loop is placed in the magnetic field, each section of it will experience the magnetic force. When a couple of these sections experience equal and opposite forces on the opposite sections of the loop, this results in a turning effect for the loop. This turning effect, due to the couple of forces, is called torque on the loop. In this figure, a uniform magnetic field of strength B is taken, in which a rectangular current loop of length L and breadth B is placed. The current in the loop is I. In the figure below, F1, F2, F3 and F4 are the forces on each section of the loop. Now we will use the right-hand rule to identify the direction of the magnetic force. Let's recall that, according to the right-hand rule, the direction of force, F1, is into the plane. The force, F3, is out of the plane. Further, the forces F2 and F4 are equal to zero, because the angle between the length along the current direction and the field is either 0 degrees or 180 degrees, as they are either parallel or anti-parallel. Now the torque on the loop is... Torque is equal to force times perpendicular distance between the forces. Thus, torque is equal to BIL times B, or torque is equal to BI times LB. We know that the area A of a rectangle is calculated by multiplying its length and breadth. Therefore, the torque on the loop will be calculated as torque is equal to BIA. Let's say the loop has n number of turns. Now the total torque on the loop is torque is equals to BIAN. When two equal forces act in the same direction at two opposite ends, there is a possibility of static equilibrium. So to have the rotation effect, there should be equal forces acting at two opposite ends or sections in opposite directions. Moving coil galvanometer works on the principle of torque on a current loop placed in the uniform magnetic field. In the construction of moving coil galvanometer, permanent concave-shaped magnets are used to provide a permanent uniform radial magnetic field so that the plane of the loop is always parallel to the magnetic field. As the torque causes the loop to rotate, the needle connected to it shows the deflection in the scale. The magnetic field results in the torque BIAN sine theta on the current loop. The torsion spring, on the other hand, provides the restoring torque C phi. Therefore, BIAN sine theta equals C phi. Here, C is torsion constant, and phi is the deflection of needle in the galvanometer. As the plane of the coil is parallel to the magnetic field, which means that the area vector of the coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field. Thus, BIAN sine 90 degrees equals C phi, which implies I is equals to C phi divided by BAN. Since the quantities CB, A and N are constants, the current in the coil is directly proportional to the deflection in the galvanometer. In this video, we have learned about how the torque is developed on a current loop placed in the magnetic field and the working of moving coil galvanometer.